I had two swollen glands in my throat, and that's when I went to my primary care physician. They didn't hurt, but they'd been there a while, so I thought better to have him tell me that it's nothing, and he sent me to an ear, nose, and throat specialist. My throat was fine, but in the CAT scan, in the upper part of my lungs, they had noticed what they called ground glass densities. I called my primary physician, Dr. Soffer, who's affiliated with Penn. His offices are in Median, Delaware County, so it's very convenient, and asked him to recommend somebody at Penn in the city. I had a CAT scan and the PET scan. When they put them on the screen, you know, you could see my rib cage and you could see this white 1 inch, and that was cancer. They asked me if I would be part of a trial study that what they were doing, where they would insert this green dye into me 24 hours before the surgery that would illuminate cancer cells that were hidden for whatever reason from CAT scans and PET scans.
But we were thinking about this new technology at the time, and we told her that we weren't exactly sure how it worked, but we had this thing that make her tumor glow, and there's a chance we might find something else. And she really didn't ask any other questions. She's like, sign me up.
The surgeon, Dr. Singhal, went in for one tumor on the lower right lobe of my right lung, but then they went searching around and spotted the other one.
We've encountered this a few times now. It's very interesting. We've gone in to do a routine operation, and all of a sudden now, since tumors are glowing, we've found other cancers that we weren't expecting.
The tumor that was not visible on the traditional CAT scan or PET scan was glowing like the Emerald City.
Miss Howitt was an interesting example. She had two spots in her other part of her lung, and we took it out and it came back to be cancer. And it really was a game changer for her, because here you have somebody who would have had a very successful cancer operation. We would have told her she was cured. She would have come back 3 years later with other spots, and she may have died. Unfortunately, we caught these spots while they were still under a centimeter. We were able to take them out, and she didn't need chemo or radiation or any further therapy.
If I'd have gone to any other facility that didn't have the green dye that's attracted to lung cancer, they never would have found the second tumor. So I thank God every day that I went to Penn. They take care of you at Penn. Penn's reputation in the country is rated with Harvard and Johns Hopkins. I live less than 30 minutes away from Penn. Why would I go to any other hospital? It would be foolish. Penn has the best. Obviously, I'm proof of that. There's no place else to go, as far as I'm concerned. I feel like I am a miraculous woman. I'm 100% cured. I'm not in remission. I'm 100% cancer-free. Some people would say lucky. Lucky is when you're getting ready to step off the curb, but you happen to see the car coming. Being cured of cancer, especially an invisible tumor, is a miracle. It's miraculous. I feel like I have an obligation to pass it on, so other people and other doctors and other researchers become aware of this procedure and what it can do in the fight against cancer. The cure is within.